to thank the West Bank Library and Texas Commission on the Arts for sponsoring this program today. We are happy on this day. 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 So clap your hands. Clap your hands. And today's songs and stories are all about animals, especially one animal that is green and has strong back legs. Any guesses on what that might be? Something that hops?
I think it's a grasshopper.
Frog!
A grasshopper is a great guess. But this is
a frog.
You can say frog with your hands like this. Take two fingers and put it under your chin. If you could not hear, you could see me, and you could see that I'm saying the word frog. Sing what I sing. There was a frog. There was a frog. An ugly frog. An ugly frog. The ugliest frog. The ugliest frog that you ever did see, that you ever did see. Well, a frog on a log, and a log in the bog. That's like a swampy place with a lot of water. And the green slime grew all around, and the green slime grew all around. Now on that frog, there was a mouth, the ugliest mouth that you ever did see. Well, a mouth on the frog, and the frog on the log, and the log in the bog. And you can help me in your slimy voices. Here we go. And the green slime grew all around, and the green slime grew all around. Now in that mouth, there was a tongue. Don't forget this part. The ugliest tongue that you ever did see. Well, a tongue in the mouth, and the mouth on the frog, and the frog in the log, and the log in the bog. And the green slime grew all around, and the green slime grew all around. Now on that tongue, there was a wart, the ugliest wart that you ever did see. Well, a wart on the tongue, and the tongue in the mouth, and the mouth on the frog, and the frog in the log, and the log in the bog. And the green slime grew all around, the green slime grew all around. Well, on that wart, there was a fly, the ugliest fly that you ever did see. Well, a fly on the wart, and the wart on the tongue. Well, I guess that's the end of that. I guess that's the end of that. I just happen to have a frog with me today, Grandmother Frog, because it's time for a poem. Grandmother Frog sat on a stone, ribbit, ribbit, ribbit. Sitting and singing, she sat there alone, ribbit, ribbit, ribbit. Then along came a fly and sat on a log. Hey, 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 come over here. Get me here on this log.
Ribbit, ribbit, ribbit.
Grandmother Frog sat on that stone.
Ribbit, ribbit, ribbit.
Sitting and thinking, she sat there alone.
Ribbit, ribbit, ribbit.
Then that foolish young fly flew off of that log. You can't catch me. And was caught on the tongue of Grandmother Frog.
Ribbit, ribbit.
Now it is time for a story. This is a story that Elvis Presley would tell if he were here today, but he's not. So I'm going to have to tell this story. It's a story found in many different picture books, and you might be able to find it at your library. The Wide Mouth Frog. Long ago, but not that far away, there lived a frog. Now, this frog was like any ordinary frog. Green skin, big bulgy eyes, strong back legs. But this frog was a little bit different because this frog had a huge, gigantic, enormous mouth. So this frog laid her eggs and she knew they were going to hatch, but she did not know what to feed her babies. But she was clever. She came up with an idea. She would go out and ask other creatures what they feed their babies, and then maybe she could get an idea on what to feed her babies. Good idea, right? Thumbs up, right? Pretty good idea? All right, so she went out and she hopped down the road. Well, you know I feel the beat. Hop, hop. That's your part. Try that. Hop, hop. Well, you know I feel the beat. Hopping down the road, hop, hop, asking what babies eat, hop, hop, plainer a la mode, hop, hop. Don't be mean to a frog that's green. I don't want no other love. Baby frogs, it's just you I'm thinking of. So there she was, hopping down the road, when she hopped through a field of flowers, and there on one of those flowers was a small creature with black and yellow gown, gossamer wings. The Wide Mouth Frog turned to that creature and said, "Excuse me, Miss BB Queen, what do you feed your babies?" And that, you know what it is. That honeybee said, "Let's eat, everybody, let's eat, let's eat, everybody, let's eat. Everybody in the whole beehive eats honey just to stay alive." I said, "Buzz, buzz, 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 ho, ho, ho." And that Wide Mouth Frog said, "Oh, honey, okay, thank you. Thank you very much." And down the road she hopped. Do, 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 hop, hop. Do, 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 hop, hop. Do, 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 hop, hop. Do, 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 hop, hop. Don't be snide to a mouth that's wide. I don't want no other love. Baby frogs, it's just you I'm thinking of. So there she was, hopping down the road looking for another creature, when she came upon a creature that had no arms. A creature that had
no legs. The wide-mouthed frog turned to that creature, and she said, "Excuse me, Miss Patty Legless, what do you feed your babies?" And that snake said one word, "Rats." "Love them tender, love them sweet, eat from head to toe. Rats, oh, such a tasty treat, and I love them so. Love them tender, love them whole, throw them on the grill. In a plate or in a bowl, rats give me such a thrill." And the wide-mouthed frog said, "Oh, rats. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much." And down the road she hopped. Do, 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 hop, hop. Do, 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 hop, hop. Do, 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 hop, hop. Do, 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 hop, hop. Don't be cruel to a frog that's cool, blooded that is. I don't want no other love, baby frogs. It's just you I'm thinking of. So there she was, hopping down the road, hopping through some trees, and there, hanging from one of those trees, was a creature with 8 legs. The wide-mouthed frog turned to that creature and said, "Excuse me, Miss Loretta Spin, what do you feed your babies?" And you know what it is. You can guess. Yes, it was a spider. And that spider said, "Well, I spin my web in a bush or a tree. I catch lots of things like a fly and a flea. My friends say I'm eating all of the bugs. I'm all filled up, do 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 do, yeah, I'm all filled up." And the wide-mouthed frog said, "Oh, bugs. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much." That's it. That is what she would feed her babies. Oh, oh, she was feeling proud of herself for answering her own question. She started hopping back home when she met another creature. This creature had a long, long head and a long, long body and a long, long, long tail, short little legs, and a whole lot of teeth. Now, even though that wide-mouthed frog knew what she was going to feed her babies, she couldn't help herself. She was curious. She turned to that creature and she said, "Excuse me, Miss Reba MacInGator, what do you feed your babies?" And that, you know what it was, that alligator said, "One for the money, 2 for the show, 3 to get ready now, go frog, go. I'm gonna tell you, we feed our babies wide-mouthed frogs. Oh-ho-ho. We could eat anything, but we love those wide-mouthed frogs. Yeah, I said, wide, wide-mouthed frogs, we love them. Wide, wide-mouthed frogs are yummy. Wide, wide-mouthed frogs, ho-ho-ho. Wide, wide-mouthed frogs, we could eat anything, but we love those wide-mouthed frogs. Yeah." And the wide-mouthed frog said, "Oh, okay, thank you. Thank you very much." And lickety split, that wide-mouthed frog was out of there because she was not going to be supper for an alligator. She hopped safely the whole way home, and the next day she gave her babies bugs for breakfast. And they all lived happily ever after. The end. I happen to have another frog with me. This frog is a musical instrument that sounds like a frog. It's made out of wood. Listen. Does that sound a little like a frog to you? It does to me too. This kind of instrument is called a rasp, and it's found all around the world. You can walk around your house, and I bet you have an instrument like this, like a rasp, at your house, because maybe at your house you have one of these. A comb. Now, this is a super giant comb, but maybe you have one too. All you need to do to make this comb into an instrument, have a comb and your finger. When you put them together, it sounds like this. A little like a frog, or even a piece of cardboard. This is corrugated cardboard, and you can see the ridges, just like the ridges on this frog's back. And when you take this cardboard and your finger, it sounds like this. Almost like a frog, just with a piece of cardboard. So walk around your house and you might find other things that can be used as musical instruments. I have another instrument that's really pretty small. I can hold it in my hand. Would you like to hear what it sounds like? Okay, listen. There is a wild frog in the pond, doo-lum-day, doo-lum-day. There is a wild frog in the pond, doo-lum-dum-day. There is a wild frog in the pond, catch her, boys, don't let her get away. Slow her down, catch her if you can. If you want to make a song of your own, doodle-um-day, doodle-um-day. If you want to make a song of your own, doodle-um-dum-day. If you want to make a song of your own, take a tune you already know. Take your time, make a rhyme, make it if you can. And that's what I did with that story. I took Elvis Presley's songs and I just put different words to those songs. You can do the same thing. But now it's time to hop like a frog. Here we go. You can hop like a frog with your whole body. You can hop like a frog with your hands. Hop, hop, hop like a frog. Hop like a frog together. Hop, hop, hop like a frog. Hop like a frog together. Put both hands up in the air. Wave them all around. Fly like a bee together. Fly, fly, fly like a bee. Fly like a bee together. Hiss, hiss, hiss like a snake. Sss, hiss like a snake together. Hiss, hiss, hiss like a snake. Sss, hiss like a snake together. Spin, spin, spin like a spider. You can put both your hands together and spin. Spin like a spider together. Scratch.
scratch, scratch, scratch like a dog. Scratch like a dog together. Scratch, scratch, scratch like a dog. Scratch like a dog together. Swim like a fish. Swim, swim, swim like a fish. Swim like a fish together. Swim, swim, swim like a fish. Swim like a fish together. Your nose on your nose. Put your finger on your toes. Put your finger on your nose. Put it on your elbow. Song, because the next story is about birds. It is a story that you can find in a book, kind of an old book, called Jenny's Hat by Ezra Jack Keats. But for this story, I'm going to tell it and show you the story. It was Jenny's birthday. Oh, now you know what it's like to have a birthday. Nayella just had a birthday, and you know how exciting it is. Oh, it is so exciting. And do you know what Jenny wanted for her birthday more than anything else? She wanted a beautiful hat, a summer hat with ribbons and colors and flowers. That's what she really wanted for her birthday. So she woke up and she stretched. Oh, you can help me. She stretched. Oh, she went into the bathroom. She combed her hair. Everybody comb your hair. Cleaning up is fun. Everybody comb your hair. Now your hair is done. She brushed her teeth. Everybody brush your teeth. Cleaning up is fun. Everybody brush your teeth. Now your teeth are done. She washed her face. Everybody wash your face, cleaning up is fun. Everybody wash your face, now your face is done. She put on her underwear. Everybody put on your underwear, cleaning up is fun. Everybody put on your underwear, now your underwear's done. Put on your shorts. Everybody put on your shorts, cleaning up is fun. Everybody put on your shorts, now your shorts are done. Put on your shirt. Everybody put on your shirt. Getting dressed is fun. Everybody put on your shirt. Now your shirt is done. Jenny was all ready for the day. She ran into the kitchen, and there on the kitchen table was a very big box. It was a present from her grandmother who lived far away. It came in the mail. Oh, Jenny was excited. Oh, I hope it's what I really want. Oh, I hope it's a hat with beautiful colors, beautiful flowers. She opened up the box. I hope. Inside the box, there was a hat, but it was just a plain old straw hat. Nothing beautiful, no flowers or ribbons. It's just a plain hat. Then Jenny thought, maybe she can make her own hat. So she walked around the house looking for something that might be able to be made into a hat. She went into the living room and she found this. What do you think? Would this make a good hat? This basket? What do you think? Yeah. We have a couple thumbs up. We have a couple thumbs down. We have more thumbs down now. Okay. So she walked around the house some more. And she walked into the kitchen. And she found this. What do you think? What do you think about this hat? Thumbs, couple thumbs down. No, couple thumbs up. Okay. Next, she walked outside and she found this. It's a flower pot. What do you think? Well, it's kind of a bright color, but thumbs up or thumbs down? Thumbs down. No. Okay. So Jenny thought, well, I'll just have to get used to my plain old hat. She put her hat on, and then, like she did every single day, Jenny took some bird seed and she went outside to feed the birds. Now, while she was feeding the birds, she was just dreaming and she was talking to herself. I really wish I had a beautiful hat with flowers and colors. That's what I really want. Well, the birds heard her wish. And the next day, she put on her hat to walk to her neighbor's house, who was having a summer party. And as she walked along, she heard, there, all around her head, birds were flying in circles around her hat. And then one bird brought a ribbon, a purple ribbon, and put it on top of her hat. One by one, those birds flew back and forth. One brought a sunflower. Wow! And slowly but surely, they covered her hat with beautiful flowers and colors and ribbons. Oh, it was amazing. Before long, her hat was covered with beautiful, beautiful flowers. And then, the most amazing thing of all, birds flew together, carrying a nest that they put on the very top of her hat. It was astounding. Well, when she walked into that party, her friend said, Jenny, look at your hat. It's amazing. And it was. She took that hat when she went home. She took it off and she put it outside so the eggs could hatch. And then sometimes she would wear her hat and sometimes she kept it in the box. And whenever she was feeling a little lonely, we all feel a little lonely sometimes. And whenever she was feeling a little sad, we all feel a little sad sometimes. She would open up that box and she would pull out that hat and she would remember her grandmother and she would remember the birds. And after that, she wasn't quite as sad or quite as lonely again. The end. I have some magic for you, but before we do that, I happen to have a real bird's nest. This is a bluebird's nest made out of grasses and twigs. You could go on YouTube and you can watch birds making nests. It takes a long time to make a nest because they have to fly back and forth and back and forth to make the nest to lay their eggs. Before we do our magic, we're going to do the wiggle worm game. Now, whenever you see the wiggle worm, you know what to do. So say what you see. Raccoon. Turtle.
Cat. Cat.
Wiggle worm. Wiggle, 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 wiggle,
wiggle. Wiggle worm, wiggle, wiggle. Frog.
Frog.
Wiggle worm.
Wiggle worm.
Wiggle worm, wiggle worm.
She's asking you to read.
Fish.
Fish.
Deer.
What else? Funny.
Raccoon.
Raccoon.
Wiggle worm.
Wiggle worm.
Oh!
Wiggle worm.
Otter.
Otter.
Hummingbird. Honey.
Honeybee.
Opossum.
Opossum.
Rabbit.
I love
rabbit.
We have time for another song. Get in your boat. Let's go on an adventure and see what we can see. Achapachanocha, achapachanocha. Ay, miss a day, miss a day, miss a doe. Achapachanocha, achapachanocha. Ay, miss a day, miss a day, miss a doe. Look around. Oh, way. I see something with strong back legs, something that we heard about today. It is a frog. This frog is not like you and I. It is a reptile. This frog does not drink water through its mouth. It drinks water through its skin. And when that frog catches a fly on its tongue, it closes its big bulgy eyes to help push it down into its stomach. Say bye, frog.
Bye, frog.
Get back in our boat. Achapachanocha, achapachanocha. Ay, miss a day, miss a day, miss a doe. Achapachanocha, achapachanocha. Ay, miss a day, miss a day, miss a doe. Look around. Oh, way. I see something with a hard shell. Any guesses?
Turtle, tortoise.
A turtle. I know this turtle lives in the water because its shell is flat. If it was big, round shell, it would be a tortoise. And I know this lives in the water. Look at its flippers. Turtles can live to be 60 years and older, and a turtle shell is made up of 60 bones all attached together. Say bye, turtle.
Bye, turtle.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Get back in your boat. Achapachanocha, achapachanocha. Ay, miss a day, miss a day, miss a doe. Achapachanocha, achapachanocha. Ay, miss a day, miss a day, miss a doe. Oh, way. I see something with beautiful soft fur. Some of them live in rivers and some live in oceans. This might be a harder one to guess. They're a mammal.
Whale.
Anyone know what this creature is? It's an otter. It is an otter. An otter is a member of the weasel family. There used to be 13 different kinds of otters, but one went extinct. So now there are 12 different kinds of otters, and they are beautiful. I was in a boat, just like we are now down in Florida, and this little creature put its head up out of the water and looked right at us, and guess what it was? It was an otter. Say bye, otter.
Bye-bye.
Get back in your boat. Achapachanocha, achapachanocha. Ay, miss a day, miss a day, miss a doe. Achapachanocha, achapachanocha. Ay, miss a day, miss a day, miss a doe. Always, always, I see something with a long tail, a long body, and a long head, and lots of teeth. I bet you can guess what it is.
Snake.
An alligator. Quick, get in the boat. Otwatch nocha, otwatch nocha, Amos, 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 no. Otwatch nocha, otwatch nocha, Amos, 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 no. Away, 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 away. It is an alligator. And this alligator has about 60 or 70 teeth. But it wears its teeth out, and when it does, it just grows another one. So it can grow 1,000 or 2,000 teeth in its lifetime. Say bye, alligator.
Bye, alligator.
Bye, alligator.
After, well, crocodile.
Now it is time for some frog magic. What do you see? Does anybody know what this is? Some of you may know. It is a baby frog, which is called a tadpole. It is.
We bubbled with the mommy frog. She put them right there.
Uh-huh.
She put it in a bubble that they can hatch in the bubble that their tail can grow.
That's right.
And they swim in the water.
Uh-huh. She lays her eggs and from the eggs.
It's bigger.
Tadpole. That's right. And then this tadpole. Let's put our tadpole inside our bag, our magic bag. We'll put our tadpole in there. And that tadpole eats algae and plants. And then its tail gets smaller and smaller and smaller. It grows big back legs. It grows front legs. And it turns into a frog. And then that frog eats bugs and dragonflies and flies and mosquitoes.
It has its own babies that repeat the life cycle.
It exactly repeats the life cycle into metamorphosis. So on the count of three, throw your food for the frog. One, two, three. Throw your bugs, your flies. Okay. I hope it works. Abracadabra, zimini zam. Turn into a frog if you can. We did it! We did it! Frog metamorphosis magic! Well, today I'm going to show you how you can make a wide mouth frog with just this, just a piece of paper. You can use any kind of paper you have at home. This is an index card, but you can just use a piece of paper. You can use different sizes. It doesn't really matter. But I'm going to show you how to make a puppet out of this flat one card. This is the secret. You bend the paper. You don't fold it. You just bend it. Take your thumb and your middle finger and put them on the ends like that. Then, with my pointer finger, I just gently push into the center to make a dent. And then I can squeeze the sides and make
hello, 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 hello.
I can make a puppet. You can draw eyes on here. You can make your wide mouth frog with big eyes. You can draw a tongue inside and make your wide mouth frog. This is one that I made. It smaller, but I drew some lips on it and some eyes.
Hello, 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 hello.
So just with a card, you can make your own puppet. And for little hands, just a little tip. If you take their fingers and push them in, it helps them to understand how to do it like that. And then you can do it on your own. Make your own frog. If you would like to make a bird, you can just take a paper plate, fold it in half, put on some feathers. You can make feathers out of paper. You can make a paper tail. You can make some eyes, and it can be a rocking bird or any way that you would like to make a bird. This is just one way. So if you want to make a bird and
a wide mouth frog,
you can do that today. So before we go, I have a friend who would love to meet you. His name is Mo. Hey, hello. Hey, how you doing? Hey, good to see you. Hello. Hello, 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 hello. Hello, 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 hello. My name is Mo. I am a monkey, in case you haven't noticed. And Kim and I are really good friends. Yeah, we're really good friends. We're really good friends. Yeah, you can see we're really good friends. We've grown attached to one another, if you know what I mean. I can't do much without her because she gives me a hand. I do. It's true. So Kim gave you songs and stories today, and me, I'm going to give you a great big sloppy monkey kiss. Put your hands up. If you have paws, put your paws up. If you have wings, put your wings up. Put them up on the count of three in bird talk. Here we go. Tweet.
Tweet.
Tweet, tweet.
Tweet.
Tweet, tweet, tweet. Catch it. Put it in your pocket. And tonight, when everything is quiet, reach in that pocket and you can remember everything that you saw and heard today. I want to thank you for being great listeners and for joining me for some songs and stories today. Have a really great summer. Give yourself a hand. Woohoo! And if anyone has a question, I'm happy to answer your question.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Question?
I have a question.
Okay. What's your question?
Well, frogs, when they go up, they have a tail. But then when after that, they get feet. And then after that, they get hands. And then they turn big as frogs.
They do. It's called metamorphosis.
And then their tail goes and their inside body.
Does anybody else have something they like to say or a question that you might have would like to ask? Armand, do you have a question that you would like to ask?
No. My brother just raised the hand. He is going crazy.
What do monkeys eat? Bananas.
They eat a lot of fruit. They do. They like bananas and mangoes and all kinds of fruit.
And minions like bananas. That's what I would add.
I like bananas too. And I like mangoes too.
Oh, I like mangoes and bananas.
I like mangoes and bananas, too. Yeah,
me too. Me too.
Because I already have a black hand.
I like your puppet. We talked about your puppet hand.
Oh, it's actually called his magic glove more.
Nice.
I turned my hand into a spider web.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you
have a great
Kim.
Summer.
Thank you for a great show. Take care. Have a good summer. Bye.
You're so welcome. Bye-bye.
Bye.